So I'm with Tina and Trevor here, who are the owners of 8 Faulkner Street in Orangeville, which is a great backsplit house in the middle of downtown. So what do you guys think? Like, the location, obviously, of your place is really good. I mean, I'm biased. I love downtown Orangeville. But, like, have you guys found it a good place to live?
Yes. Yeah. It's perfect. You can walk everywhere. Everything you need is within walking distance.
Totally, right? All the great restaurants, all the shopping, the festivals. It's really good that way, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, and schools and offices as well.
So did your house have like a superpower? Like something that's so awesome about your house that is like someone should know about it?
I like the fact that there's many areas to do things in. The kitchen's a large enough kitchen where more than one person can be in there preparing a meal. The dining area, we have Christmas dinner here and it's easily seats 12 people. Once we put the canvas back on the pergola, you have a lovely sitting area there. The trees kind of close off the medical center so it's quiet and the birds are there and you have bird feeders. Nice barbecue area and
It's a spectacular, entertaining house because, especially on the weekends, there's no one at the medical building. So you have unlimited parking to have people over. It's opened up enough that people can be in the living room and we set up the island as a buffet so people can come and go and eat. The backyard the same way. You can have people coming and going out through that back bathroom. It's really great if you like to have people over.
Looking back at your house, I see that you have a garage in your house, but that wasn't always there, was it?
I didn't like the way that there used to be a carport in the house, and it was just much better to have it enclosed. We put the garage on about 10 years ago.
Awesome. Well, that was a good addition.
Thank you.
One of the things I like the best about your house, when you walk in, you come through the front hallway and then boom, it just opens up into this great room. Now, was it always laid out to have a dining, living and kitchen all in one big room?
There was a bit of a divider between the kitchen and the rest, so you didn't have access to your guests
visually.
And it was made of paneling, so we opened that up.
Very dated.
Awesome. So now you have that big like two-tiered island, which I think is a showstopper. Was the kitchen always like that size?
The configuration was redone. There was white melamine cupboards, so only cupboards. The fridge and the stove were completely at two ends of the kitchen, which wasn't very functional. So we kind of made it a little more functional too.
It was great. Yeah. I love the way it looks. It really shows like current is what people want nowadays. I love that. Heading downstairs, you have that really great family room. I like how that flows. It's all wide open as well. That TV wall though is pretty cool. What'd you do over there?
It's a nice cozy area down there. We can sit and watch TV, have the fireplace on. It doesn't matter whether it's cold nights or not. It's a comforting area.
And that stone wall is actually pulled out so you can have wiring behind it. So you can't see all the wiring all your electronics.
Yeah. Oh, pretty cool. Okay, I didn't know that. Then you head up the stairs, which is very uncommon to go back upstairs after you've gone to a lower level in a backsplit. And you have all that encaustic tile on the wall, which I love. And that laundry room is really great. I mean, you've got a lot of space there. But what made you put another bathroom back there? It was such a good idea, the three-piece bathroom.
For access for people, if you had people over for a barbecue, so they didn't have to go in through your house, just right in. And if there was any gardening being done or anything, if you're dirty, it's all tile when you walk in, so you don't have to walk across hardwood floor, and in you go. And it's a wider doorway that was actually designed to wheel a wheelchair through.
Amazing. Well thought out. If we were to go outside, you've got that big yard in the back, mostly fenced in.
Yeah, and, mostly.
Then you head upstairs, you have 3 bedrooms, all with hardwood floor. And then we have that bathroom, which looks like it's been updated. What did you guys end up doing there?
The bathroom was not very functional. So we reconfigured where everything was and updated it a great deal. All new tile, floor, and tubs around. And most recently, we redid the vanity area with a new sink and a touchless faucet.
The motion sensor faucet is less than a year old.
Awesome. Yeah. I love those bells and whistles.
It's secretly designed in some ways for a short person like me. The two-tier countertop is so I can work at a lower level. The shower is designed to lower the head for someone like me.
I love that.
Lots of ideas.
Yeah, little secret short people hidden tricks.
It's great. Well, thanks so much, guys, for letting me do this and like getting it straight from the horse's mouth, that they say. You guys know the house better than anybody does. So thank you so much for all your time here.
No problem.
All right. Thanks a lot, Ross.